Hi there, this is Hoohaa Sports Today, your daily sports update and review show covering all that's happening in your world of football and beyond. Well, we are about a third of the season through and it's the trials and tribulations of the London clubs that are taking much of the focus this season. From the start, it was Arsenal. Four losses from the first seven and most of the fans wanted Arsene Wenger sacked, greatly backed by this result. Or you can look at it this way. And all it took Wenger, or possibly Robin van Persie, was the next five games, and the fans are getting a sense that they are in the title hunt. Now focus switches to Chelsea. It has been brewing for some time, but after that loss to Liverpool on Sunday, the heat is on the team and the manager. Here are some comments on their official Facebook page, and it's not pretty. Eric Coco gets it started. He says, home form and late goals have cost them. Leila Kasim from Singapore gives us a short novel. You may pause this video just to read what her comments are. But she does take John Obi Mikel to task, but the main pressure is on Andre Villas-Boas. Here's a double from Keno Chris and Joseph John, wanting AVB's exit, and a snapshot of some other get rid of AVB comments. But as an analysis of the game with Liverpool, I think Mikel Dennis has got it spot on. He says it's their attack-minded defenders that are causing the midfield to be overworked. And when the back four fail to track back, they concede. Ola Bode agrees that the all-out attacking style is what's hurting Chelsea. And that could be absolutely true. Like this article written by Will Tidy in the Bleacher Report and his so-called expose on Chelsea's shortcomings. And he lists an interesting stat to support that. Under AVB, Chelsea concede an average 1.4 goals per game. Under previous stewardship, Ancelotti held a 0.86 per game. Poor old Avram Grant had an impressive 0.68 per game, while Jose Mourinho held a 0.4. So there could be some truth in that. You should read the entire article, it's good. Just head on over to bleacherreport.com and search for Chelsea shortcomings within their site. So should AVB go then? It's going to cost Chelsea if they do that. A lot. The Daily Mail says that it will cost the Blues £20 million, as there's still a 2.5 years left on his £150,000 a week contract. Tribal Football says that the total loss would be a staggering 33 plus million, which includes the 30 million compensation they paid to Porto to bring him over. In fact, Abramovich has a habit of paying compensation. He pays to get rid of people, quite unlike a typical Russian mob. Take a look at this. Since the Russian took over, he paid 4 million to Claudio Ranieri, double digits for Mourinho and Scolari, amounting to £61.1 million. So what is £20 million going to dent? Well, time is ticking. End to end, here's a re-quote from the Bleacher Report article to what BBC's Phil McNulty said. Roman Abramovich's legendary impatience ensures Stamford Bridge's clock always ticks faster in times of trouble. Unquote. Till tomorrow from the team and I, it's bye for now.